Hello students, welcome to the lesson 1 of the chapter 6. So chapter 6 is your introduction to finite element methods. Okay, so all the things related to finite element methods will be explained, all the theory portion and few problems which we have to do in the finite element methods will be dealt in this particular chapter. Okay, so your first lesson is brief history of the development of FEM. FEM is nothing but your finite element method. So how the historical development of FEM took place, so let us see in this particular lesson. Okay. So first of all, let us see what is your finite element method. See, your finite element method is a numerical method to solve systems of partial differential equations. So if there are some n number of partial differential equations and you have to solve this, you have to use your numerical method, which is called as the finite element method. So what finite element method does is it reduces a PDE, is nothing but your partial differential equation system, to a system of algebraic equations. Those are your normal linear equations. So a finite element method will reduce your PDE into your algebraic equations, and this can be solved using any traditional linear algebraic techniques. So normally, if partial differential equation is there, it is very difficult for you to solve and get the answer. So what FEM will do is it will convert the partial differential equations into your algebraic equations, so that if there are system of algebraic equation, you can easily solve using your traditional linear algebraic techniques. So that is what is the work of your finite element method. So in general term, if you want to tell, this is the actual definition of your FEM, finite element method. So it is a method for dividing up a very complicated problem into small elements that can be solved in relation to each other. So what happens is, if there is a complicated structure, analyzing that structure will become very difficult. So what finite element method will do, it will divide that complicated structure into number of small elements or simple structures, and then try to get a relationship between each element and solve that particular individual problems, and then finally come up with a solution for that particular complicated structure. So that is what your finite element method will do. Okay, so if you want to see how it is developed, so finite element method was initially developed for the analysis of aircraft structures. So initially, when they started with this finite element method, it was started with the application to aircraft structures, but the wider nature of the theory enables it to be applied for varieties of boundary value problems in engineering. So what happened, because of the wide application of this, they have started applying these finite element method for various boundary value engineering problems, where the solution had to be found out in the region or domain of the system that subjected to the satisfaction of certain boundary conditions. So if there is some system which has to be solved and there are some particular boundary conditions applied to it, then in those type of problems, applying finite element method was becoming easier. So initially, when it was started in the aircraft structure, then based on its wide application, it went on spreading into your all other engineering problems which were related to your boundary value problems. So to see one by one, so this, starting from here, is the history. So your finite element analysis can be tracked back to the work by Alexander Henrik of in 1941 and Richard Cartwright in 1943. So these two were the first persons to start the work on your finite element analysis. So what did Henrik of do? He introduced the framework method in which a plane elastic medium was represented as collection of bars and beams. So these bars and beams he represented in a framework manner like this. So in an elastic medium, that means they obeyed the Hooke's law. So he started his work with doing this. Then in 1950s, the solution of large number of simultaneous equation become possible because of digital computers. So initially it was done manually by him, but in 1950s when digital computers were introduced, a large number of simultaneous equations could have been solved very easily, right? In 1960, Ray W. Kauf, he published the first paper in which the term finite element was used. And in 1965, the first conference on finite elements was held. So this is how the historical development happened. So Henry Kauf introduced first, then in 1950s, digital computers came into existence, because of which solving of large number of simultaneous equations became easy. And in 1960, Ray W. Kauf first published a term or the paper called in which the term finite element method was used. And in 1965, a first conference was held on finite elements. And in the 1967, the first book on finite element method was published by two authors, Zenquiz and Chang. So these two members published the first book on the finite element method. So moving further, in the late 1970s, FEM became applicable to wide variety of engineering problems. And in late 1970, this was a breakthrough. So in late 1970, what happened? Commercial softwares for your FEM method came into, they originated, like your Abacus, Nastron, and Ansys. Nowadays you see these softwares, right? They are the latest version. But way back in 1970s, the first commercial packages of these finite element method software packages originated. Then because of this, finite element programs on supercomputers led to rapid development of your CAD systems. And in 1980s, algorithm on electromagnetic application, fluid flow and thermal analysis were developed with the use of the finite element programs. So not only for engineering structures, for aircraft structures, on electromagnetic application, for fluid flow application, for thermal analysis application, everywhere finite element programming was being used starting from 1980s. Okay, then engineers can evaluate ways to control the vibrations and extend the use of flexibility. So developable structures in space using finite element method and other methods in the 1990s. So in 1990s, what happened? Engineers tried to apply the finite element method to control vibration in structures, be it a mechanical structure, an aeronautical structure, or a civil structure. Okay, so that helped them to apply on the vibrational characteristics. Okay, then trends have adopted to solve fully coupled solution of fluid flow with structural interactions, biomechanics related problems with a higher level of accuracy were observed in this decade. So after that, here also they started applying. In 1990s, it was applied to solve fluid flow coupled problems, structural interaction problems, biomechanics related problems, or the problems where high level of accuracy was needed. There all engineers and scientists started applying the finite element method. So with the development of finite element method, together with tremendous increase in the computing power and the convenience, today it is possible to understand structural behavior with levels of accuracy. So because of the development of finite element method and computers, nowadays we can easily analyze the structure, real time, how the structural behavior will happen. We can do it analytically and visualize. So that is what is the main importance of your finite element method, and how finite element method came into existence is what is the history of it. Okay, so this was in fact beyond the imagination before the computer age. If computer age was not coming into existence, we could not have imagined all this. And because computer age came into existence, and because finite element method became popular, nowadays any kind of structure can be analyzed easily in the real term application. So this is the historical development. So if you want to see the chronological order of finite element method, created a small table for that. So year wise, what development happened, who was the scholar who developed it, and theoretically what development happened is given here. So in 1941, Henrik Off presented a solution of elastic problem using one dimensional element. This we already saw in the previous slide. Then in 1943, McHenry also tried with the same problem. So in 1943, Courant introduced shape functions. You will be studying about shape functions. The notation for shape functions is N in the coming classes. So over a rectangular sub, over triangular subregions to model the whole region. So what he did is, suppose there was a structure like this, try to divide it into many rectangles and try to solve the problem. Okay, so that is what he did in his research. So we'll see how these elements and all in the coming classes. Right, in 1970 and in 1953, Leib did his work. So what did he do? He developed the force flexibility matrix for structural problems and also developed the displacement, that's your stiffness method for your structural problem. So flexibility method and stiffness method he developed for the structural problem using what? Using the finite element methods. Right. Then in 1954, Argyris and Kalis developed the matrix structural analysis method using energy principles. So already energy principles were available. So using these energy principles, he tried to develop the matrix structural analysis, because in FEM, solving the equations using matrix method will become easier. Okay. And then in 1956, Turner, Clough and Martin derived stiffness matrix for trusses, beams, 2D plane stress elements, and also they derived the direct, they developed the direct stiffness method. So we already have seen all these stiffness matrices and the direct stiffness method, but these people try to do it in terms of your finite element method. Then in 1960, Clough introduced the phase or the term called as finite element. This I told you in the previous slide. Okay, then in 1960, Turner and a few other authors with him, they studied the large deflection and the thermal analysis. Right, in 1961, Mollis developed plate bending element stiffness matrix in his paper. And then in 1961, Martin developed the tetrahedral stiffness matrix for 3D problems. Right, in 1962, Gellner and his mates developed material non-linearity using FEM. So all these works were done in terms of finite element method. Okay, then coming to 1960s, Grafton and Stormy developed the curve bell bending element stiffness matrix. Then in 1963, again Molsch applied variational formula to solve non-structural problems. If there were any non-structural problems, he applied the finite element method to solve those. Okay, and in 1965, Clough and his mates developed the 3D elements of asymmetric solids. So what are asymmetric solids? I'll be telling you in further classes. Right, so in 1967 and 1968, Zenkiewicz published his first book on finite element. Also, he did a research in viscous elasticity problems. Then in 1969, Sobes and Lee adopted weighted residual method in structural analysis. Right, in 1972, Odin book on nonlinear continua. He wrote a book on your nonlinear continua. Okay, and in 1976, Belchenkov, he worked on large displacement nonlinear dynamic behaviors. And finally, in 1997, lot of new element developments, convergence studies, the development of supercomputers, the availability of powerful microcomputers, the development of user-friendly general purpose finite element software, everything came into existence. And from there on, the finite element method is going on developing, and nowadays it has reached its ultimatum and any type of problem can be solved. So this is your brief historical development. If you want in chronological order, you can write this right in your exam, or mix these points along with the chronological order and give a answer for your history of your finite element, brief history of your development of your finite element method.